さんおはようございます、こんにちは、こんばんは。元気ですか？
元気ですか？ I'm always your echo。
元気ですか？元気ですか？
元気ですか？
皆さん
元気です、
うん、今日はまた東京は雨が降ってます。
台風が来てます。
あ、台風来てるね、うん、そうそうそう、今週末台風 is coming、 そう、今週末ぐらいにヒットするのかな。
あ、yeah, I think 台風 is coming to Tokyo around weekend. So I will stay at home as usual.
I feel like every weekend is raining these days.
Yeah, and don't you feel like it's raining on Thursdays very often? Whenever we do live,
that is true. It's raining. Kenji は雨女ですか？
そうかも。Because when I try to go to hiking, it often rains.
Oh.
So, 雨女 is a word. 雨 is rain.
Rain.
女 is girl.
Yeah, woman. So, who, someone who calls rainy weather. 雨女.
Yeah, when the person tries to do something,
yeah,
it rains.
And also, there's 晴れ女. 晴れ男.
Are you 晴れ女?
違います。私はね、風かな。
風女.
風女.
晴れ女 means.Sunny girl.、
うん、
so when the girl tried to do something,、yeah. it's sunny.
It's nice, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. Unfortunately, it's not me.
No, it's not. Rainy Thursdays, James さん、元気。ドニーさん、おはよう。プリンス、ん？プリンセスさん、こんにちは。ウェリントンさん。久しぶりに出た、これ。
なんだね。
お、ジョセフさん、ありがとう。Thank you.ジェネシスさん、こんにちは。先生、リザ。
Yes.
リザだけど。
Yes.
ありがとう。Thank you. 似てるからね。
リザ、リザ。
こんばんは、メキシコから。オーラーマイラさん。
クラシアス。
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 グラシアス、グラシアス。
わかんない。I think, but I know the spelling, but、yeah. I don't know how to pronounce it.
I think Mexican Spanish and、Spanish is different, right? Gracias or gracias.
Ah, I hear the pronunciation is slightly different.
Gracias, gracias, gracias.
Even like British English and American English、
True.
Are different.
Yeah.
Even you use more British English, I feel like. Because, For example, yeah.
Yeah, but now I'm more like
mixed.
Mix Japanese.American English.
Yeah, for example, what is kumi in English?
Rubbish.
Yeah, rubbish is British English. And trash is American.
Trash, garbage.
Yeah, garbage.
Yeah. Yeah, so many words, I wonder like which one to use every time I say garbage.
Yeah, but I feel like you often use British English. Yeah, you are in London, so.
Right. ビクトルさん、アルゼンチンから、リサさんとケイジンさん、こんにちは。こんにちは。
こんにちは。オラ。
皆さんの国の天気はどうですか今。How's the weather in your country?
I hope it's sunny and happy. Happy weather.
Yes. まあでもね、雨は雨で大事だよね。
大事。For the earth.
For the earth.
And I also stay at home, so...、うん、I like being at home on a rainy day. I like the sound and I feel like the house is so comfy.
Actually, I don't feel bad when it's rainy day and staying at home. But when it's sunny and nice weather outside and staying home, I sometimes feel, oh, maybe I should go out. I'm wasting my time.
Lovely day. Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, Arbery, my first time actually watching live.
First time. いらっしゃいませ。
Hope you like it!
Welcome!
We do the live at the same time every week, so please join it next week too.
ジェシカ・ティボーさん、カナダ人だって、from Canada. おカナダ珍しいかもね、あんまり
いない、ね、結構
あ、いる
いるんじゃない、
本当、
いや、
yeah. かな、
Hello! I was there! Okay!
Alright! Today's topic is...Japanese possessive particle no.
So we are talking about possessive particle, but if you want to learn even more particles,
JLPT worksheet book?
Right! So you can download.
Da, 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 da. Yes. This. Oh yeah, here's Particles. Nice.
Yes. So you can download everything for free in the link in the description. And
also worksheet.
Wow, so cool. Inside you can practice learning kanji. Mm. I mean, you can practice writing and then also learn the vocabulary. So check it out. Oh. It's really useful with this. I want to show this page.
Kanji.
Isn't that so cool? This is how I learned kanji. Hmm. Like there's a big kanji and meaning and how to read and then I practice
again and again and again. Yes. And also there's a video about particle no on our site and on YouTube.
Yeah, so Risa hosted.
Check it out. Okay, so let's dive into the lesson. Okay. So the English, my. In Japanese, watashi no.
Watashi no.
So as you can see, watashi meaning I, and no is a particle. Watashi no.
So in English, it's more like, for example, Risa's bag, chimchim's water.
Chimuchimi no mizu. Chimuchimi is water.
Yeah. So chimchim's the apostrophe s. Yes. Yeah. It's like no. It's like apostrophe s.
Right. Watashi no. And your. Anata no.
Anata means you. No is su. So it literally means use.
Use.
But in English you say your.
Yours.
Your.
Yeah,
your.
And his. Kare no. Kare no.
So kare, he, no, his.
And then her. Kanojo no. Kanojo no.
Kanojo means
her or she.
So no is possessive particle, so like s. Kanojo no.
Yeah, so it's actually hers as well. Yeah. In depend on the sentence.
True. You mean like, oh, whose bag is it? Oh, it's hers.
It's hers.
It's hers. It's his. It's ours. So it's like that. So it can be hers too. But today we are going to focus on more like this part. This part.
Right. はい、次。Our.
Oh,
私たちの。
So, 私たち, as you can guess, is we or us.
No. No. 私たちのライブストリーム。
It's our live stream.
あなたのライブストリーム。
Your live stream.
Okay. And their. 彼らの。彼らの。
So you see, 彼。Here, but if you put ra, it become them.
Oh, Mushurafu. Sorry, San said, "Anata, 失礼ですよね." No, anata is polite. The 失礼 one is omae, like you. Anata is polite.
Yeah, it's polite. But very often, Japanese people use their name. For example, ah, Lisa さんは何が好きですか?
Right.
Instead of anata wa?
Anata sounds really formal. So it sounds like maybe in an interview or something like that.
Yeah, or a written form. So very often people use their name with polite suffix like Lisa-san, or Lisa-chan, or Lisa-kun, Lisa-sama.
Like Victor-san.
Yeah.
私の猫の名前は花です。
Cute. 猫の名前です。Ah! Cat's name!
Good catch!
So as you can see, this is how the word is formed.
Right.
So, 私 cat's name. 猫の名前。
猫の名前。Noun plus no plus noun.
So just like s apostrophe s in English. Right. So b is belong to a.
So the let's make the simple sentence. A no. B means B belongs to A.
Right, so this noun is belongs to this.
Right.
Very often it's also translated is as of in English.
Yeah.
But then the order is opposite, right? So for example, 私のカバン.
My bag?
Yeah, my bag. But if you translate it in using of, it will be back of mind. Back of mind. So the order is different. So please be careful. It's opposite. B is belong to A.
Let's make a sentence using this simple pattern.
Mm-hmm.
So, for example, let's put A as 私, meaning I, and then B, 部屋, meaning room. And you want to say my room. How would you say? 私の部屋.
My room.
My room. 私の部屋. So with this pattern, can you guys make a sentence?
Yes, and Neko の名前 is a great example, just like that.
Alan さん、午後の紅茶. It's a name of the drink. Can you mention the name?
Yeah, I think it's okay. It's kind of Japanese culture.
So, 午後の紅茶 meaning afternoon tea. Afternoon's tea.
Yeah, it literally means afternoon's tea. But yeah, afternoon tea. So when two nouns are connected, very often Japanese people put no.
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 私の服 My clothes.
刑
人の服
刑人の
clothes.
So you can put someone's name or just pronouns like me, you, her, him.
僕の好きな色は青です。ロジャー・カラムさん。Nice! My favorite color is blue.
Right, so 私 is very polite, but when you are male, you can use 僕. Right?
Ah, you can also say 僕.
How about 俺?
you can say it too, but I personally prefer 僕.
俺 is used by very manly men?
Yeah,
or like...
I don't know, it's okay depending on how they use, but ore sounds more masculine.
Yeah, masculine. Yeah, like,
hey. Depend on how you say, but I have some impression like ore.
Yeah, so it's boku and ore are used by male men. And also they use watashi too in a polite formal situation.
Right. Watashi. Watashi.ソニー・ハーシュさん、私の可愛いです。どういう意味だろう ？What does this mean?
So 可愛い is an adjective. So you have to use noun if you want to use no here. So probably 私の猫は可愛いです。
そういうことか。
いや、私の猫は私にの猫。
Can't。ふふふ先生、私の熊。
You have.Bear?
My bear?
My bear?
お、ナイスはマーロンさん。これはマーロンさんの財布です。Perfect!
マーロンさんの財布。
Yes.
財布 means wallet.
財布 belongs to マーロンさん。
Yes, it's マーロンさんの財布。
Okay, so, Facebook も好き。あ、これちょっと違うかな。好きな色は紫です。Nice color. のが入ってなかったけど。
ジョセフさんの好きな色は
Ah.
So if you want to use this format, you just need to put 私の or your name, or someone's name.
シャーランさん said, 私の部屋は青くて明るいです。Nice.
So 私の部屋。
大丈夫?
This example, my room. Nice.
Okay, 僕の猫は可愛いです。いいですね。
猫可愛い。
ね、みんな結構猫が好きみたいだね。
Me too.
Or some people might think Chimi Chimi is a cat and talking about.
Chimi Chimi is Chimi Chimi.
Original.
Yeah, original.
私の弟の名前はマルコスです。ウェリントンさん。Perfect. My brother's name is Marcus. 私の車。Good. My car. Okay, so let's have a look these sentences.The first one, あなたの名前は何ですか?
So, what's your name? What is your name?
So, here, の。
So, this is noun A, noun B. あなた、right. means you.
So, first noun modifies the second noun. あなたの名前。So, your name.
Yeah, your name.わis a topping marking particle.
And なんですか? What is it?
What is it? They use ですか because it's a polite ending.
あなたの名前は何ですか? 私の名前はアランです. Perfect timing, アランさん. すごい。パーフェクトタイミング。
OK。
はい。And yes, like Alan さん said, 私の名前は、
トゥルルル
です。私の名前はリサです。
私の名前はケイジンです。私の名前、私の名前はチムチミです。
チムチミ、そんな可愛い声なんだ。
うん、あんまり喋れない
。あんまり喋んないよね、チムチミ。
話すと可愛い。
私の名前、わちゃん。可愛い。なんだろう、ワリードさんかな、わちゃん。
It's your nickname. That's cute. So you just put your name here and say this. 私の名前はトゥルルです。
Okay. Can we go to the next one? Oh, 私の名前はタウンです。ありがとう、タウンさん。僕の名前はベックです。Nice. 私の名前はウェリントンです。We know your name.
Yeah.
私の名前、私の名前はムクタンサランです。ありがとうございます。ハウーさん。私の名前はハウです。Okay.
Great job, everyone. You guys used カタカナ. That's great because it's a foreign name. So very often your name is written in カタカナ. And Risa will probably use your kanji name, right?
Kanji name?
Yeah, you write your name in kanji.
Right.
Yeah. I do. Since many foreigners, I mean most foreigners don't have kanji, you will use カタカナ in your name.
Ah, すごいそうそう. プリティさん、あなたの名前はリサです。そうです。あなたの名前はケイジンです。あなたの名前はチムチミだ。
ありがとうございます。
Okay. Can I use 僕は Sure.
Yes. If you're male. Yes.
Okay. 私の名前はエビで、エビ、エビです。エビーさん。エビ。
エビ。Cute. In Japanese, it means shrimp. かわいい。
エビちゃん。Okay. All right. So the next one. 明日から英語のテストが始まります。
English test starts tomorrow. Oh no.
So 明日 meaning tomorrow から
from
英語
English language
の、
today's key.
テスト.
So 英語のテスト literally means English test.So, test of English、
が
Subject, mark, and particle
始まります
Start! So,、English test starts from tomorrow、
明日から英語のテストが始まります、
So, here, not only these pronouns, you can actually put any noun here to connect two words
Right
Like English test, so here, instead of English's testYou just use adjective here, right? But in Japanese, people very often use noun plus no, and these become kind of like adjective.
Right. Yeah. 英語のテストが始まります。And it continues. だから今日の夜は英語を勉強します。
Of course. So I'm going to study English this evening. Or I will study English this evening.
Isn't it weird?
What
is this?
That's why you're staring at your English.
I'm going to. I'm going to study English this evening.
Yeah. I don't know if you noticed, but Risa used present tense here because in Japanese there's no future tense. So present tense does the work of, does the role of future tense.Yes. Isn't that so great? So you don't have to study more. If you know present tense, you can cover future and present.
Sorry. Rene san said, 私の靴下は臭いです. Perfect sentence.
My socks are stinks.
You know, actually, if you just wash it with hot water, super hot water, it might go on the smell.
I see. Then doesn't it make the socks smaller?Is it okay?
But you can wear it and
make it bigger.
Yeah, stretch it.
Stretch it.
Okay, so break down this sentence. だから meaning.
So, therefore, that's why.
今日
Today.
の particle.
Particle s apostrophe s.
夜
Night, evening.
は
is topping marking particle.
英語
English language.
What?
Object working particle.
勉強します。
Study or will study or going to study.、
うん、だから今日の夜は英語を勉強します。
Therefore, today's night, it literally means today's night,、うん、I'm going to study English.
Yes.、
So、today's night in English is like tonight or this evening.、
うん、皆さん、今日の夜何か予定はありますか？
So, tonight, do you have any plan? Do you have any plan for today's evening? This evening, tonight?
今日の夜 tonight.
今日の夜台風だから
台風が来るね
台風、うん、So this evening, 台風 is coming to Tokyo, so、うん、I'll stay at home、
うん、家にいます
Yeah、How about you guys?、
うん、
How about you, Risa?
私は、動物に会いに行きますI'm going to 犬と猫に会いに行きます
かわいい
かわいい
ワンちゃんと猫ちゃん。
そうそう、ワンちゃん。Cat and dogs.
Yeah.
Ivy さん。Ivy read as Ivy.
Mm.
Mm. Ivy. But if you simplify, maybe it sounds like Abby.
Ah.
Ivy.
I see. Ivy.
Okay.
Oh, Eric Lopez. What does 皆さん means? 皆さん means everyone.
皆さん。
Yeah, everyone.Hi, people.
Yes.
People, everyone.
はい。
はい。
はい。はい。彼女は音楽の先生をしています。
She's a music teacher.
彼女。
She.
は。
Her. Topic marking particle.
音楽。
Music.
の。
S. Apostrophe S.
先生。
Teacher.
を。
Object marking particle. 知っています meaning is doing. So it literally means she's doing a music teacher. But in English, you say just music teacher. You use adjective, and in Japanese, often this noun plus no become adjective like music.
Yes.
音楽の先生 means music teacher.
先生 meaning teacher, what kind of 音楽 music teacher?
Yes.
音楽の先生。
うん。
Okay, 彼女は音楽の先生をしています。先生の家にはピアノとバイオリンがあります。
She has a piano and a violin at home.
うん。So, 先生 meaning
teacher
の
possessive particle like apostrophe S or of
家には
So, 家 means home, house. Ni is location marking particle, like at, in, and wa is topic marking particle. So, in English, it literally means、mm. as for at home. So, you are talking about her house, her
家には
home. 家には
Piano.
Piano. So, it's a loan word.
To.
And.
Violin.
Violin.合ってるよ。
バイオリンが、
a particle, subject marking particle,
あります。
There is.、
うん、
so it literally means there are a piano and a violin at her house.、
うん、it must be a nice house.
Yeah, piano and violin.
Plus violin.
Yeah, さすが music teacher.
ね。
Yeah.
Okay. So as you can see, we use lots of this particle. No.In a sentence or while we making speaking, so it's good to know.
Yes.
No. Oh, John さん、今日の夜日本語のライブストリームを見る。Or maybe 今日の日本語のライブストリームを見ている。Because you're watching it, right?
Or maybe he will watch it again. 、
mm.
That would be great. Review it if you're not sure.
Yes.
Oh, this.Anime that a lot of people mentioned last time.
Ah, 4月は君の嘘。
うん。
ね、これ調べたけど、絵可愛かったよ。
うん。
It's a nice
picture. 私も調べた。I also checked it because a lot of people mentioned it.
うん。
Yeah.
Oh, JD Shin Bugarin さん said, 私のフィリピンです。My Philippine.
or you, do you want to say my country? Then you, you will say 私の国。
Okay, so
okay, so quiz time.
Quiz time.
Poo poo.
So let's
poo poo. Poo poo.
Let's make a sentence. What is? Sorry. When is your birthday?
When is your birthday? By the way, people want to see you. So.
Ah, 本当だ。どんどん近く。So when is your birthday?
So can you make a sentence in Japanese? How can you say this in Japanese?
Yes.And obviously, you're going to use this particle.
Yes.
No.
Please give us a hint.
Okay. So, so when in Japanese is いつ。Birthday is 誕生日。
And your is あなたの。
あなたの。
So you can use these words.
タートウィックさん、あなたの誕生日はいつですか ?When is your birthday? Perfect!
ダダダダダーン
Exactly as it is! あなたの誕生日はいつですか
?Great job! And Alan さん、oh! Alan さん answered this!、
Oh!
私の誕生日は
?He answered.、8月8日。8月の8日。Infinity. Infinity. Okay! あ、みんな答えてくれてる。
Thank you.
え、ああそういうことか。アマニライハンさん先生、難しい。助けて先生。
It's called Help Me Teacher.
Check our videos there. It's more explaining clearly in the video.
Actually, you can also download through this particle cheat sheet where you can find the link in the description. Yeah, we are giving away this particle cheat sheet for free, so check it out. You can even learn more particles, not only no, but other things.
Yes, I hope it will help. Okay.
Okay, so what's our next quiz?
Hi, the next one is...これにしましょう。
はい。
ありがとう。What did you eat this morning?
What did you eat this morning? Can you make this sentence in Japanese? Can you write it in Japanese? Using no.、
So, this morning.
Okay. So, this evening was 今日の夜。So, I can guess this morning is 今日の
朝。Morning. 今日の朝。
What is what in Japanese?
何？
何？ Yeah, we mentioned this. 何ですか？
何？ Same 漢字。
Yeah, same 漢字。
Okay. 一気にコメントが止まったね。So, eat this morning. Oh, Tatwick さんありがとう。
You are
great.
So smart.
Yes. 今朝は
Good student.
あれ今日の朝何を食べましたか、今日すごいね。As it is. すごいタトリックさん。Also, ビクトルさん said, 今朝は何を食べましたか So, 今朝 meaning this morning as well. Good.
Yes. タトリックさん, do you have our,
yeah.
our papers? How do you know all the answers exactly?
Yes. 今朝は何を食べましたか？ムシャ、ムシュラフさん。
Yeah, it's hard to read foreign names, so we are sorry if we make mistake in pronouncing your name.
ベルジャンさん said, あなたの朝ごはんですか？あなたの朝ごはんです。
Your
breakfast. 今日の朝は何を食べましたか？ストハさん。お、サンジャイさん said, 今日の朝カレーライスを食べました。いいな。
That's rice. I want to say nice and then curry rice. That's rice. Yeah, I want a curry.
面白い。 That's nice.
That's rice.
Now what are you eating? 今何を食べていますか？
So what I'm
wanna は空気を食べてます。
She's eating air.
Air. あ、朝ごはんは食べませんでした、プリンセスさん。
Instead, you will have lunch, right?
うん。ウェリントンさん said, I can't type fast. So
yeah, why? Yeah. It's difficult to type fast, especially in foreign language. So if you keep typing when Risa teaches new phrase sentences, you will gradually improve. So always try to type.
Ivy さん said, 今日の朝、あ、コメントがどっか行っちゃった。
A lot of people said, that's rice.
But she said she ate rice and egg.That's rice.
That's rice.
パンとバターを食べました。カルロさんせ。
Butter.
うん。何？ダラダラダラ。Okay. So, じゃあどっちにしようかな。
どっちにしようかな。
はい。
はい。
The last quiz. Whose bag is this? Whose bag is this?
No. So, what is whose in Japanese?、Mm.
Whose.
ドゥルル
誰の
and、how about this? How can I say this in Japanese?
これはこの、
How about bag? What is bag in Japanese?
Bag、
oh,
or you can also say カバン、But bag is more common. Long words from English、
So Risa gave you the vocabulary. Can you now connect those words and make a sentence?
Joseph さん said, このカバンは誰ですか? Who's this bag?
Who is this bag?
Who's this bag?
So the bag is a person?
So that's why you need to put this particle の、このカバンは誰のですか?
誰の。As we mentioned before, this can be just my, your, his, but it can also mean...Mine, yours, his, hers, ours, theirs.
このカバンは誰のですか? Andres さん Yes!
That's great! Oh, Wellington さん is also good. 誰のカバンですか? Da da da! So can you see this?
これは誰のカバンですか?
So, whose bag is this?、これは means this. 誰のカバン? Whose bag?、The sky is.
Is it?
Yeah, is it? Polite question ending.、
Oh, レネさん、ありがとう。ケージンのライスのバッグってどういうこと? ケージンのライスバッ
グ? Maybe I mentioned rice too many times today. Rice bag?
これはリサのカバンです。Yes.
Yeah, this so, is Risa's bag.
Right, answer it. You have a tricky name. Okay. このカバンは誰のですか? Fruits. Punchy さん, yes. 俺のカバンです。Sojiro さん, right.
It's my bag.
今日私はラーメンを食べました。いいですね。何ラーメンですか? 豚骨、醤油、塩、味噌。
Or
cup noodle.
Because it's not easy to find Japanese ramen restaurant in foreign countries. I mean, there are a lot, but it's not daily food. So I think a lot of people enjoy cup noodle.
たまに食べたくなるよね、ラーメンって。
食べたくなる。なんか寒い時も
食べたくなる。寒い時も食べたくなるし。
Because the soup is really hot.
Yeah.
So, I hope you enjoyed today's lesson.
So, today's lesson was Japanese possessive particle の.
Yes, and then if you want to learn more particles, check out the link in the description. So, you can learn more particles, and also you can learn more kanji with our JLPT worksheet. By the way, even though you don't take JLPT test, it's most no kanji, so check it out.
Okay, so thank you so much for watching. And、next week's topic will be conjunctive adverbs.
For example,
therefore, and however,
but,、by the way,
and it will be October 15.
Yeah, it will be next Thursday at the same time. So、we will see you again at the same time.
10月の15日ですね。
October 15th.
はい、皆さんコメントどうもありがとうございます。まだ何も喋ってませんでしたお、今 I saw your comment OK、 良い一日をお過ごしください。
Yeah, have a great day.
Adios.
I was expecting big sound like
バイバイ、またね、ありがとう。
See you next week.